Many people think that Vedas is only about theology, but it talks about science too. Let us see, how is it possible? Firstly, let's know about what actually Vedas talking about. It talks about Agni, Vayu, Varuna, Indra, Soma, Surya, Chandra, etc. But here when we say Agni, actually it refers to a fire. But in our culture, everything is described as a person. Same case for Vayu, it's an air in reality. But we see as a person, Vayudev. Same case for Surya, Chandra, Varuna, which is a rain, but seen as a person. Even earth is seen as a Bhumi. Ganga is a river, but we see as Ganga Devi. So let's get clear that actually Vedas are not talking about any persons, but it talks about the nature. So if you go in deep, we find Shiva, Vishnu and Brahma too. But how could we see these three as persons? It must be a nature too. If yes, then what it could be? We shall decode it with their properties. If we see Vishnu, who always takes avatar and saves dharma, the righteousness, which indicates he protects the positivity. Even paper tree is also referred as a Vishnu because it gives maximum time pure oxygen. So whatever positivity is there, that could be taken as Vishnu. So this suits with the proton, which has positive charge. Next, coming to Shiva, who is called Nirguna, Nirakara, that means it has no plus nor minus charge. So it could be equal to neutron, which has no charge as well. And Shiva is called Nirakara. So sometimes it is also referred as a space, because Nirakara means formless. Next, if we see Brahma, then it could be an electron, but it has negative charge. So even Brahma told lie once as per our scriptures, and Brahma has no temples as well, more than two or three. So overall, you have to understand that you should not see it as a person. If you want to understand science through the Vedas, as I clearly said, you should not see it as persons. Then only you can find Vedas scientifically.